Your Excellency, the President Uhuru Kenyatta, Her Excellency, the First Lady Margaret Kenyatta, Your Excellency, the Deputy President William Ruto, Mrs. Wabui Korimo, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, all protocol observed, good morning. This is my tribute to Bob. Bob, you truly were a great man, a man of values, a man full of love for humanity. These are just some of the qualities that made you an exceptional CEO who led Safaricom for the last 9 years. I remember when you joined Safaricom and we were all worried as to whether you'd fit in the shoes of Michael Joseph. This was made worse because you came in at a time of great turbulence in the industry. The first half year results that you announced reported a loss. Losses were unheard of at Safaricom. Personally, I was devastated. But thereafter, you made tough decisions that turned the company around, and since then, you registered growth year on year. You indeed created your own shoes. Bob, you are totally against corruption. I remember that day I was in your office and we were having a conversation along this topic and you told me, Esther, I have a wife, I have a mother and children. I cannot afford to live an unethical life. What will I tell them? This confirmed to me that your fight against corruption was personal. You taught me to ask the same question. I pray many of us today would make the same decision to live a corruption-free life. Many times, I came to your office seeking for a solution for the dealers. You called us your dealers. You truly cared for us. We felt that as long as you were at the helm of Safaricom, the business was secure. I'm sure the stakeholders of the business would be interested in having a successor that will protect the Safaricom brand, which has been in the forefront of transforming lives, creating employment, and I'm sure the taxman celebrates Safaricom too. Let us remember this as we search for your successor, for a big brother cannot afford to trample on everyone else. I've also learned from you on how to become a consultative leader. You valued consulting your team before you gave a solution, and I came to respect this style of management. No wonder you have left behind a great team and partnerships. You truly believed that when people come together, great things happen. Oftentimes, in the dealer's platform, you refer to me as your sister. This was very humbling. It proved that you treasured and valued genuine friendship, something you acknowledge was very difficult to get at your level. This morning, as I was going through the messages that we shared with Bob over time, I came across one message that he sent for me in October 2017. That is when I had done an interview for the Business Daily. And he told me, great interview today. It was humble, honest, and authentic. And I asked myself, in October probably, when you wrote that message, you were in pains. What made you send me that message? And I could only conclude it is because You represented people who are humble, people who are honest, and people who are authentic. I can testify before this crowd that if there is anything that Bob hated, it's people who are proud. Now that you cared this much, Bob, I'm sure you are surrounded by great friends in heaven. When I asked you to do the foreword for my book, you did not hesitate to say yes. After the book was published, I came to your office and gave a copy for yourself and for your wife, Wambui. I was feeling so small, and I remember telling you, I do not know even why I wrote this book. Honestly, I could not justify it to myself. You told me, shut up, Esther. The fact that you have learned a successful business, one with a journey, against a background of values and principle, is all that matters. This really encouraged me, and I'll be forever grateful. On behalf of the Dealers Association, thank you for always making time for us, challenging us to be better business leaders and people. Thank you for your dedication and inspiring us to greatness. It is said, what you leave behind is not what is engraved in stone monuments, but what is woven into the lives of others. Until we meet again, rest well, Bob, rest well.